Well, ain't that the way. One minute I don't have two caps to rub together. The next, Jack Cabot awkwardly stumbles into my life.
Hancock says newcomers are welcome in the third rail. Go on in.
Don't mind if I do. If a man from Beacon Hill turns up and goes on and on about his missing kid sister, you listen to him howl. If he's willing to part with that Beacon Hill money of his, you take the job. Now, I don't usually do this kind of gig, especially with my own missing person case to solve. But Jack Cabot wouldn't take no for an answer. Retainer fees, expenses paid, whatever it took to find Imogene. I need information.
What? Another one of you mercs looking for MacReady?
And I'm guessing I won't get it from these mouth-breathing, riff-raff regulars. Instead, I'll take my chances with her.
Better sell some.
Excuse me, miss.
Before someone swipes it.
What's the matter, handsome? Don't tell me you didn't like the song.
Song? I just got here, dollface, but I'll tell you what you want to hear.
I love the song. It was perfect.
Oh, well, thank you. A girl tries her best. Now, there's something special about you, isn't there? Don't tell me. Let me guess. It's your eyes. Quick and intense. I bet you never miss a detail, You like what you see? So what brings a man like you to my part of town?
I came here for the music.
Flatterer, I think you and I are gonna get along. So it's my turn to answer questions, right? What can I do for you?
Do you know Imogene Cabot?
Imogene? Sure. I know her. I haven't seen her in a while, though. Are you a friend of hers?
I just need to talk to her.
Why are you looking for her, honey?
I'm trying to help her. Do you know where she is or not?
No need to get impatient with me. I just don't consider it polite to gossip to any stranger who walks into the club.
Please, tell me what you know.
There was this preacher fella who used to come in here all the time. One of the slick ones. Always going on about remaking your life and so on. Most of the customers wouldn't give him the time of day, but Imogene, she latched on to him for some reason. I don't suppose it hurt that he was easy on the eyes. Intense. Some women find that irresistible.
Pam, would you come over here a minute?
Is there a problem, Miss Magnolia?
No, this fine gentleman here was just looking for Imogene. Do you happen to know where that preacher fella came from?
Brother Thomas?
Yes, that's right. The one Imogene was always hanging on.
Had to throw him out. Wouldn't stop bothering customers with that salvation racket. Kept going on and on about joining him at the back bay. Then he'd shove those stupid flyers in your face. Here, I kept one of them, just in case he didn't pay his bar tab.
Well, thanks, honey. You were a big help.
Anything for you, miss.
I hope Imogene's all right. I didn't much like the idea of her going off with that preacher fella.
Before I left, she told me she'd hope I'd stay around for a bit more sweet talk. And under normal circumstances, a man would jump on her like a hungry flea at a dog show, but my life is hardly normal. My circumstances are hardly normal. And it's just as filthy as I remember. The old hat shell. And there I saw him. The preacher man's goons. I could go in guns blazing, but I suppose I should do this with a bit of finesse. Information is the key, after all. And even though I feel like a pair of gums at a dentist's office, I knew I had to do what had to be done. Anything to get paid, right? And there he was. Over the funk of the tire fire, I could smell that cheap suit. There's my guy. So let's put a smile on that old face of mine and see if I can become yet another lost soul.
Welcome, neighbor. We're always glad to see a new face around here. Tell me something. You ever feel like this whole world is broken? Do you ever wonder why things can't be the way they were in the good old days?
The whole world is broken.
That's what I used to think. Until I found a way to make a difference. to transform my life, and maybe everyone else's too. We call ourselves the Pillars of the Community. We're a pretty new movement, so you may not have heard of us. But we're growing fast all across the Commonwealth, and you can be part of this exciting future. Step right this way, and I'll be happy to tell you all about our movement and how you can be a part of it.
Sounds like bullshit to me.
Sounds good.
Well, that's just fantastic. I know you're going to fit right in around here. Right this way, neighbor.
I hope you decide to become one of the pillars of the community.
I hope you decide to change your life today.
I'm always excited to welcome a new member into our fold. Don't worry, I don't bite. Alrighty, I hope you're as excited as I am. This is one of my favorite parts of the job, getting to welcome new members into our movement. The first step is simple. You have to learn to give up your attachment to material possessions in order to gain the ability to have true wealth, health, and happiness. Just go ahead and give me everything you own, and I'll initiate you as a first-level pillar of the community.
You've got to be kidding. You want me to give you everything I have?
The first step is the hardest, neighbor. But it's the only way to cast off your old life and start on the road towards your future health, wealth, and happiness. Don't you think that's worth a small, temporary sacrifice?
What do I get in return for giving you everything I own?
You're still stuck in old thinking. You're still clinging to your old life. But that's what you came here to give up. And the first step is to shed yourself of your material possessions.
You can't seriously think I'm handing over all my stuff.
The world is full of suckers, pal. Just look outside. Every one of them handed over everything they owned in return for... Well, hope. Sure, it's false hope, but hey, it was worth it to them. You can tell yourself whatever you want, but you're leaving here naked or horizontal. Your choice.
At least Karen was kind enough to offer both at the same time.
What if I've changed my mind and don't want to join anymore?
No, sorry. I'm afraid we're past that point. You really do need to give me everything. Now.
I'm walking out of here. Your choice what you want to do about it.
Ah. You're not worth the trouble. Plenty of easier marks. Get out of here before I change my mind.
I'm looking for Imogen Cabot.
Not that it's any of your business, but she and I are just having a little relationship trouble. You know how it is. She's not seeing anybody until she cools off.
You're not holding her prisoner, are you?
No, she's not a prisoner. She's just locked in her room until she calms down. She was acting crazy, threatening to run off. You know how women can get.
I'm a friend of the family. Maybe I can talk some sense into her.
I said she wasn't seeing anybody, including you.
I'm going to see her, one way or another. Your choice.
You picked the wrong guy to mess with, pal.
I'd suggest he'd sit down before he fall down, but let's be honest. I knew it'd be something I enjoy. Ah, hell. This is why you can't have nice conversations with nice people, Fox. You're just not a people person. Ow. Damn it. Ugh.
Keep him off me!
That'll do it. Something's wrong. Damn gun's jamming. Gotta get out of here now. That's your present. Still stuck. On my way, lady. Gotta get the hop on this son of a bitch. Surprise. that certainly could have gone better. And last time I... Oh, okay. All right, sorry. Time out. Holy shit. Do you see this right now? Damn. Got the devil in you. This is... See my wiggle? My twist? My forbidden dance? Seriously, this is like straight out of like... Aliens. What the fuck is happening? I'm really freaked out. Oh god, that is so unsettling. Made me break character. Fuck. Okay. Okay, that was so fucked. God, stop it! Stop it! Okay. Okay. Time in. Now that I've made sure to make an enemy out of my tailor, I decided to see what's behind door number one.
You must be Imogene.
Don't tell me. Jack sent you.
Who's this old broad? I thought I was looking for a kid's sister.
You're Jack's sister? I was expecting someone a bit... younger.
You really know how to flatter a lady, don't you? Just to be clear, I'm Jack's younger sister, the baby of the family. Once I get home and get some of Jack's serum, I'll be back to my usual stunning self.
Wait a minute. Serum? That mysterious package from Parsons?
Jack has a serum that reverses aging?
It's more like it halts aging. I started taking it when I was 32, so normally that's what I look like. You'll see once I get my treatment. I was well known as one of the belles of Boston society. Back when there was any.
Yeah, whatever. Let's get going already.
It wasn't my idea for you to come down here poking your nose into my business.
I'm just here to make sure you're okay.
I'm fine, as you can see. I was just waiting to see if Thomas would come to his senses. But since you've already gone to all this trouble, I may as well leave now. I was bored with Thomas anyway. He seemed so interesting at first. But after we got here, he turned out to be just another brute. He actually thought it could force me to join his absurd cult.
Your boyfriend's dead. Let's go.
Thomas? He wasn't my boyfriend. We had some fun together, that's all. Besides, he shouldn't have locked me in here. Don't worry, I'll find my own way home. I'm not quite ready to face Mother. And thank you. I really do appreciate you coming to find me. Even though I didn't actually need rescuing.
Mysterious serums. Crackpot cult leaders. This definitely wasn't a normal gig. And I wanted answers as much as I wanted my caps. So I went back to the Beacon Hill Palace of the Cabots to get some.
This is maddening.
Oh my
Edward,
god, it's
switch
happening.
Over to the Hartley modulator. Do you copy?
See now. How's this?
Oh, that's done it. Edward, what's going on there?
We're under attack. They're inside the building.
Inside? Can you keep them out of the basement?
I'm trying, Jack. I've never seen raiders this... For God's sake, Sammy, the doorway, right there. Sorry, things are a little busy around here right now.
Listen, if they're inside the building, you have to go to the office and shut down the elevator. You can't risk them getting to Lorenzo.
Got it. Office. Elevator. You better round up whoever you can and get...
Hello? Edward? There's no signal at all. I've lost him.
I always knew it would end this way. I never should have allowed you to lock up Lorenzo in that place.
That isn't helping, Mother. And as I recall, using the serum was your idea, not mine.
So what are you going to do?
I said I'll handle it. I'm thinking.
Oh. What do you want?
What's going on?
That was Edward. He's at Parsons, the old asylum. They're under attack by raiders. It's strange. The guards have held off raiders before without any trouble. I don't know what's gone wrong this time.
I found Imogene. She's fine.
Oh, yes. Good.
At least one small comfort on this terrible day.
You'll be wanting to be paid, of course. Edward usually handles these things. Caps is what you use for currency, isn't that right? Here. I hope that's the right amount. Now, we really need to focus on the current emergency.
How can you be so callous about your sister's safety?
I wonder if these could be the same raiders that stole that last shipment. If some of them had used the undiluted serum, it could explain their unusual success against Edward's men.
What exactly does this serum do?
I suppose it's time you knew. The main benefit of the serum is to halt aging. My family and I are all over 400 years old. But it also confers other side effects, especially in the undiluted form that the Raiders stole. It increases strength and resistance to all kinds of physical damage. So at least some of these Raiders may be much more dangerous than the ones you're used to dealing with.
Where do you get this serum from?
My father, Lorenzo Cabot, is confined in Parsons. He became dangerously unstable after handling an artifact he found on an archaeological dig in Arabia. He gained various seemingly paranormal powers, as well as becoming increasingly irrational and violent. In the end, I had no choice but to confine him, for his own safety, as well as ours.
Jack, are you sure it's wise telling him all this?
In the course of my attempts to cure him, I discovered that the artifact had introduced anomalies into his blood. So the source of his insanity is also the basis of the treatments that have prolonged all our lives. The irony isn't lost on me, but if he were to escape from Parsons, I would lose my father forever. I will not allow that to happen. Not to mention that the artifact has made him paranoid, homicidally violent, and endowed with extraordinary abilities.
Then I guess we'd better make sure he doesn't get loose.
Exactly right. Before we go, I need you to understand something. When we get to Parsons, you need to do exactly what I tell you. Nothing more, nothing less. Is that clear?
I'm not that great at taking orders.
Then it's time to learn, or neither one of us is likely to leave Parsons alive. Make sure you have whatever you'll need for a serious battle. I'll wait for you outside.
Jack, be careful. And try not to hurt him.
I love Father at least as much as you do. But you know as well as I do that if he gets free, there will only be one option.
Don't let it come to that, please.
I'll do my best, Mother. And if Imogene finally comes home, for God's sake, don't let her leave again until I get back. Now I really do have to go.
Excuse me.
I don't need anything right now, thank you.
Well, it looks like my job isn't done just yet after all. But first things first, better sit down before this migraine of mine gets any worse. Starting to see things.
We'll have to kill him, you know. And all the rest of them.
Well, that was different. Looks like I better stay away from that expensive Cabot whiskey they keep hiding. Oh, this day is just full of surprises. And I hate surprises.